Teachers, guests, and most important, for the students of the class of 2024, welcome to graduation night. I'm excited to kick off BASIS Scottsdale's 17th commencement ceremony, where we look forward to recognizing the incredible students who will be walking across the stage tonight. I'd like to start by recognizing a few people who are both on stage and not on stage right now, but who played a significant role in putting this ceremony together. I'd like to start by thanking our college counselors, Amber Ellico and Ryan Worthington, for putting so much time into this. Thanks to Eden Freeland for taking care of all the small details. Thank you to Paul Flores and David Allman for making sure these kids know where they're supposed to be tonight. Mr. Hathaway and his ensemble who played our music. Julie Kearney, who's here on behalf of the BASIS Ed Central Office. And lastly, a huge thanks as always to our incredible boosters. They provided the flowers tonight. And they also have their consistent support throughout the year with everything from our senior breakfast on the first day to the senior walk on the last day. If everyone please take a second and recognize all these people. To the parents, extended family, and friends joining us, thank you for all the support you've shown to these students. While giving tours of the building, I'm often asked for examples of what sets our school apart, and one of my go-to answers is always the dedication of our parents. You've taken on the responsibility of guiding your student through the challenges of high school, and I'm sure there were times when that was a difficult and probably even a thankless job. The kids get to sit in the front row tonight, but this journey started 18 years ago with sleep-deprived parents who let their imaginations run wild with every possible crazy scenario to worry about as their baby went from being a toddler to a teenager. Now we're here at graduation with all these kids who used to be your little babies about to walk across this stage. And the one thing that hasn't changed is still the room full of most likely sleep-deprived parents coming up with now even crazier scenarios to worry about as you all prepare to go to college. So graduates, I want you to stand up right now. Turn around, find your families and say thank you. To the graduates, I hope that your time at BASIS Scottsdale was both challenging and rewarding. It's too much to ask for it to have been perfect, but I do hope that you look back and appreciate all that you've accomplished. Academically, you've proven that you can do well, but we know that doesn't mean much if as a person you don't do good. And you really have done some incredible things for our school community. You built up sports programs, pep rallies, painted parking spots, you formed relationships with teachers that will last long after tonight, and you laid the foundation for future graduating classes. We've missed the energy and personalities brought by seniors since you left in February. We wish you the best with whatever comes next, and we were lucky to have you as students. So enjoy tonight, because it's all about you. Let's go ahead and get started. Our first speaker tonight will tell anyone who listens that he serves the realm. And he means that because he literally does everything in our school. He teaches the biggest span of grades of any teacher in the building. He runs early bird, he delivers mail, paints classrooms, and he knows more student names than probably any other staff member. His claim to fame is being asked in his interview years ago how he would like to structure his classroom, and he responded by saying, "I don't know, I envision, you know, taking a classroom of students out to a secret hideout in the woods so that we can read poetry together, and eventually have that end with everyone standing on desks crying out, 'Oh, Captain, my Captain.'" To which Mr. Witz replied, "I think that's already been done. And if you don't get that joke, ask your parents about it later." Please welcome one of my favorite people, Mr. Alex Kolbachuk.
Thank you for those kind words, Tyler. The speech is printed right here, but I kind of always like pulling it out of the suit pocket. So, just before I start, I was thinking about this on the way over. In addition to all those things that Tyler mentioned, I just want to tell you about my Wednesday today, because I know it's term projects and I don't have one, so it looks like I'm just pacing around the building. But in the span of about 5 hours today, I got Garcia a burrito, got him a prime hydration drink. I had to go get tortilla chips because Chad Carey brought salsa but no chips. Then I got a text from Paul Flores at 1 o'clock saying he's not gonna be able to get his Euros in time for our trip next week because he banks at a subpar financial institution. So I had to order Euros for Paul, and then 20 minutes after that he said, can you go get David's tassels back at the building? So I just thought it was funny, I was still doing all these little things. And Garcia also told me that he needed a tie, so I brought him a tie, but then he showed up with a tie. I thought I was gonna have to tie it for him because I had to tie it for him last year, but anyway. just always something happening. So anyway, thank you and good evening. Given my advanced age, it might come as a surprise to most of you that this is actually the first commencement address I've ever given. It seems that the traumatic rejection I suffered for many years in middle and high school has continued well into adulthood, and even here, where I have done everything in my power to earn a spot on this coveted dais. Lest any of you are worried about how I will perform during my maiden voyage, please know that while this is the first time I've given a commencement speech, it's actually the second time in the past 2 years that I've written one. That is no matter, however, as I am used to worthier pedagogues eclipsing me. Anyway, so much for my introductory whine and feeble attempts at humor. In all seriousness, I cannot express how deeply honored I feel to be up here speaking. It is certainly a tremendous boost to my fragile ego and, more importantly, entirely apt. If early reports are to be believed, the competition for this honor was indeed fierce, and I cannot shake the belief that somebody was clearly looking out for me. Indeed, I strongly suspect that our administration fudged the numbers somewhere along the way, knowing full well that this worthy and humble apparatchik was the appropriate choice for the class of 2024. I say appropriate because in many ways, I feel like you were my first group of kids at BASIS. Even though you were technically my second group of fifth graders, I never quite connected with the class of 2023 in the same way as I did with you. I mean, to be perfectly frank, I always felt like kind of ridiculous around them, like an imposter of sorts, a stowaway on a voyage I had no business being on. I mean, this may no doubt stem from the fact that I didn't teach them in high school, but it may also just be a matter of sensibility. The bro factor in this class, for example, is certainly more familiar to me given my own origins in the crucible of an all-boys Catholic school. But it's not just the critical mass of dudes who eerily resemble about half of my high school class that has made your class particularly dear to me. It's the sheer profusion of unique individuals that comprise this group. It is the depth of character I've had the good fortune of observing for many years, and it's the generosity that has so often emanated from such unexpected sources. I know parents are dubious of that last claim, but it will be clear in due time. So while it may seem strange to hear a 41-year-old ne'er-do-well who became something of a renegade English teacher express gratitude towards students who successfully challenged his sanity and patience for almost a decade, I find myself unable to think of any other word that adequately captures my sentiments. Indeed, in my dotage, I've come to reflect more and more on the importance of gratitude, especially so because the world that awaits you can so often seem plagued by its absence. At this point, since I've been speaking in cliches and generalities, you could be forgiven for asking how your beloved and benevolent pedagogue, Virgil to your Dante, or Gandalf to your Bilbo Baggins, or whichever one you like, how could I feel this way towards such a motley crew? See what I did there? Like every answer in an English class, this one too is complicated. As a recovering graduate student, once used to somewhat more rarefied air than a fifth grade classroom, I would have preferred to spend my days talking about books instead of corralling intrepid students pretending to be ninjas, or watching a student attempt to dislocate his shoulder on a daily basis by aggressively raising his hand, or mopping up repeated deluges of tears stemming from causes as varied as being grounded from one's books to getting a bad score on an insignificant fifth grade math test. You guys will know the names of all these people. I left them out. I'm not sure if my friends in Tin can recall the fateful afternoon I have in mind, but I definitely can. The legend himself, my doppelganger and hero, Bill Weaver, eviscerated many fifth grade egos that day. Indeed, the destruction was such that even the normally stoic Tiger Knee wore a face scarred by tears and riven by disappointment. I remember that day because everybody came in and they're going, I don't know, it must have been a bad day. So, but let's not make this a roast. That would be, as Darth Vader once said, all too easy. So yes, I would not have listed herding wannabe ninjas and watching kids cry for dumb reasons as my life goals. But if, as a younger man, I was unprepared for some of the nonsense that comes along with a job teaching little kids, I was also unable to see, in my headstrong myopia, how incredibly touched I would often be. As just one representative example, and here I get to do this again. Consider this piece of paper, which has been on my fridge for the past 8 years. I sort of forgot it was there. It was just, it's there, and I found it when I was moving. What is it, you might be wondering? My question, exactly, upon unearthing this little treasure. It's an unsigned note containing barely veiled clues to the identity of a student who secretly left me some Indian food many years ago. Obviously somebody in your class. The charm and endearment of this little missive resides both in the obvious evidence of generosity and in the fact that this student went ahead and underlined the subjects, verbs, and direct objects in the clues she wrote. So, you can see it right here. I think this is either a testament to my magnificent teaching or to anonymous students' deep love of grammar. I sort of think it's neither of those, to be honest. Nobody really has a deep love of grammar except maybe the inimitable Scott Woods. And magnificent is not how I would describe my performance. Unique, in all senses of that term, is probably a better descriptor. Scott, your name was actually written in here. I didn't just say it because I knew you were there. Anyway, I did not have any of this on my bingo card, and yet I am grateful that I did not. For no small part of the joy I have experienced in knowing you has to do with how unexpected it has all been. Whatever trepidation or insecurity I felt about taking a job teaching fifth grade was swiftly eradicated upon learning that spending time with 11-year-olds was often less of an emotional burden than hanging out with my actual friends, who, right around the time I took this job, decided it was time for them to start talking about pool filters, garage doors, and yard maintenance. Hashtag y'all. So while I've started to wade into these tepid waters myself, I still would prefer to talk to little kids about the claws they've made out of paper, or roll my eyes as young men on the cusp of adulthood cling desperately to their youth by wearing the same size shorts they did in fifth grade, while attempting to wrestle in the middle of the classroom. I learned while writing this that it is incredibly difficult to describe what this job has meant to me, and even more difficult to make my relationship to it instructive to you. Graduation speakers are, at the very least, expected to send you forth with some words of wisdom that will guide your life for the next 4 years, hopefully longer, and they often rely heavily on cliche to do it. I must confess, I am puzzled by this custom. After all, I'm not convinced you really listened to me when you were my students, and so I'm not sure why you would start now. However, on the off chance that you are listening, let me give it a go. The course of one's life, to paraphrase Shakespeare, never runs smooth. The chances that your life will not be what you expected it to be are quite high. Did I ever think I would end up where I did and via the circuitous, at times torturous path I did? This does not have to be a source of frustration or anger, although it may sometimes be. There's a divinity that shapes our ends, says Hamlet, but I've been known to call it the universe's logic in order to make it sound more like a scientific principle. So as you prepare to apocalyptically descend upon the unsuspecting world, I implore you to be open to the possibility of changing whatever grand vision you have about your life. The best thing about being the author of your own story, the cliches are creeping in here, but they're appropriate, is that you can always change your sense of what the overall pattern is. You have the power to interpret, say, rejection from a college program, a job, a dorm room, as an indication that life has something else in store for you. You can choose to look at now having to cut the crusts off your sandwiches yourselves as a colossal tragedy, the death knell of your once comfortable life, or you can choose to see it as the moment that catapults you to the next level of human superstardom. I'm jesting, of course, but the point is simple. I have yet to meet a person who's unhappy about where they went to college, and everybody I know more or less feels that they are where they should be in their lives. It is not an easy road, and it takes considerable intellectual energy and time to arrive at this perspective. But there's no reason you can't start to play the long game now, to begin to cultivate that more expansive vision as you reflect on where you've been and where you're going. If you are in search of something a little more concrete, a little more portable from your speaker than this pseudo-philosophical rigmarole, then I would simply say this. Learn how money works, learn how to cook, and for God's sake, read some books. Thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Covalciuc. Next, we have our first student speaker, Viraj Amin. He will be attending the University of Missouri, Kansas City, enrolling in the BA/MD program, where he will be consuming two things, textbooks and that world-famous barbecue sprinkled with his own special spice, creatine.
Thank you, Mr. Garvey, for that lovely address. And class of 2024, how are we doing today? With that, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, cherished parents, and my remarkable fellow graduates, today is not just a day of celebration, but a moment of triumph and reflection as we mark the culmination of our academic journey. As we gather here, surrounded by the ones who have supported us throughout our endeavors, let us take a moment to acknowledge the extraordinary achievements of our class. To our esteemed faculty, you have been more than just educators. You have been mentors, guides, and champions of our potential. You have challenged us to think critically, to push boundaries, and to strive for excellence in all that we do. Your dedication to our growth and development has left an undeniable mark on each of us, and we are eternally grateful for your commitment. And let us not to forget the unsung heroes of our journey, our counselors, Mr. Worthington and Ms. Alica. Can we all take a moment to give them a round of applause for putting up with our late night emails, last minute requests, and letting us sit in their offices for hours on hours. Their patience, guidance, and support has been instrumental in our success, and for that, we are truly grateful. To my brother Vishesh and my beloved parents, your support, encouragement, and belief in my abilities have been the cornerstone of my journey. From the earliest days of our childhood to the present moment, your presence and sacrifices have shaped me into the person I am today, and for that, I am forever grateful. Let us also extend some gratitude to heroes who make our school feel like home. Ms. Mitra. Ms. Mitra, our beloved hall monitor, whose compassion, kindness, and selflessness have touched the lives of each student she encounters. And let us not forget the smiling faces of Ms. Blair and Ms. Gordon every day. Their warmth and positivity have lit up our darkest days and made our school feel like a second home. Our class of 2024, I can confidently say, will be remembered as one of the greatest BASIS classes of all time. With 15 perfect GPAs, 17 national merit finalists, 3 Koch scholars, 8 Arizona State Science Fair winners, a future collegiate athlete, and Hassan, and a presidential scholar, we have undoubtedly left an undeniable mark on our school's history, and we should be proud of that. I am truly, immensely proud to stand amongst such an exceptional group of individuals. To my fellow graduates, you are not just classmates, you are friends, confidants, and allies on this journey called life. Together, we have navigated the highs and lows, the triumphs and setbacks, and emerged stronger and more resilient than ever. The memories we have created, the lessons we have learned, and the bonds we have formed will forever be cherished as we embark on the next chapter of our lives. As we stand on the brink of the future, let us embrace the limitless possibilities that lie ahead with courage, optimism, and determination. Let us remember that every obstacle is an opportunity in disguise, every setback a chance to grow, and every failure a stepping stone towards success. In the words of Oprah Winfrey, the biggest adventure you can take is to live the life of your dreams. As we set sail for new horizons, let us dare to dream big, to pursue our passions with zeal, and to never settle for anything less than our truest selves. Let us be the architects of our destinies, the masters of our fate, and the change makers of tomorrow. Class of 2024, as we bid farewell to this chapter of our lives and embrace the unknown that lies ahead, let us do so with gratitude in our hearts, excitement in our souls, and a sense of purpose that knows no bounds. Congratulations, truly, to each and every one of you. May your futures be filled with boundless opportunities, endless possibilities, and unparalleled success. Thank you so much. I love each one of you.
Thank you, Viraj. Our next student speaker, Stephanie Lobodănescu. will be attending the Honors College at American University, double majoring in International Relations and Economics, where she'll spend her time crushing the competition at speech and debate tournaments and deciding which outfit to knit next. She wants a shout out to speech and debate because she, quote, just loves those kids. Please welcome Stephanie Lobodănescu.
I want to extend my most sincere gratitude to every single family member, friend, faculty and administration member, and supporter of the incredibly talented class of 2024. Because without you, none of us would have the privilege of walking this stage tonight. I also wanted to thank my wonderful parents, as well as my grandparents. Te iubesc, mami, tati, bunica și bunicu. Mulțumesc pentru tot ce ai făcut pentru mine în viața mea. My amazing friends, both in my grade and in other grades, and every teacher and administration member who's ever had the care and patience to be an educator in my life. If you know me, you know I'm a bit of an easy crier, so I'm gonna try and get through this speech without it. Tonight, I wanted to speak about our graduating class specifically. 74 students, a group of the most talented, passionate, driven, dedicated people I know. I've been lucky enough to attend BASIS Scottsdale since fifth grade, and I've seen the changes that students here have made to not just themselves as people, but to the school, to the communities around them. I've watched us go from little kids who would forget their lunch boxes in the NPR every day, complain about going to AE and stress about pre-comps, and I've seen us become people with incredible goals and accomplishments beyond what any of us could have imagined back then. I get to tell people that I'm friends with creatives and innovators, nonprofit founders, national champions, researchers, talented speakers, and above all, change makers. Of course, being part of such a talented community has its challenges. The biggest of which, I would say, is watching such an unbelievable class be so incredibly hard on themselves. I think BASIS is one of the only places in the world where such capable and intelligent individuals so frequently put themselves down and refuse to acknowledge and celebrate their accomplishments, especially considering that at BASIS, achievements that are unthinkable for the average person are accomplished so effortlessly and passionately by the students here. I want to remind you all that your successes are seen, recognized, and appreciated by everyone around you. Your journey, your efforts, and your dedication deserve to be celebrated without reservation or qualification. If anyone has ever told you that you're not enough, they're wrong. If anyone has ever put down a single moment that has given you happiness or excitement, they're wrong. If anyone has ever made you feel like you're too much, too loud, too driven, too outspoken, too passionate, too ambitious, they are wrong. We need people like you to make the changes that they want to see in the world, to go above and beyond, to do the extraordinary. Every single one of you is capable of unfathomable accomplishments. And the fact that you're here right now in this auditorium is proof of that. It's an undeniable testament to your determination, your effort, your potential, but most of all, your strength. I want you to take a second, whether that be right now, as you walk across the stage, as you toss your hats into the air, or maybe as you cry on your bed at home missing your friends, to think back on what you've done until now. Remember your best moments, remember your worst moments, but most of all, remember that in the end, those memories made you who you are today. Those words of encouragement from your teacher inspired you to keep going, the support from your friends kept you sane, but your drive and your intellect got you to where you are now. I want to congratulate you all on all of your achievements up until now. And remind you that this is just the beginning of the incredible lives I know we are all going to lead. I know that I would not be the person I am today without my fellow classmates especially. And you all inspire me to do bigger and better things every single day. As cliche as it sounds, you all are my second family. And I can't express how proud I am of everything that we have been through together. I mentioned earlier that I was lucky to attend BASIS Scottsdale, but I think I've been luckier still to have had the chance to grow up with the amazing young adults graduating tonight. You've made it this far, and you will make it even further. Thank you for the honor of being part of the class of 2024.
Thank you, Stephanie. At BASIS Charter Schools, one of the most exceptional aspects of our curriculum is the Senior Projects and the Senior Research Projects program, which provides students with a platform to showcase their knowledge and research skills that they've been refining throughout their time at BASIS. This year at BASIS Scottsdale, we witnessed outstanding dedication and ingenuity from our graduating seniors in their senior projects. From developing project proposals to delivering formal presentations, these students demonstrated a commitment to academic excellence and a passion for those subjects that they chose. We are thrilled to announce our school's recipient of the BASIS Educational Venture Scholarship for the class of 2024. This prestigious scholarship, valued at $5,000, is awarded to the student who has displayed the highest quality project, engagement, and achievement. The selection process for the BASIS Educational Ventures Scholarship was overseen by the co-chairman of BASIS Educational Ventures, Patty and Peter Pizan, and was involved in a rigorous evaluation by both our school nomination committee and an examination by the coordinator himself. Each nomination was carefully reviewed based on criteria such as proposal submission, research execution, community engagement, final product quality, and presentation skills. While all our seniors presented remarkable projects that demonstrated curiosity and critical thinking that they developed over years of study. After much deliberation, we are proud to announce that the recipient is Alistair Pete. Alistair has not only excelled academically, but has also demonstrated exceptional initiative, professionalism, and creativity throughout their senior project. We commend Alistair for their outstanding achievement and wish them continued success as they pursue higher education. As we celebrate our 2024 BASIS Educational Venture Scholarship winner today, let us also recognize the invaluable support of Alistair's teachers and staff, as well as the parents and families who guided and supported these students all along their academic journey. Once again, please join us in congratulating Alistair Pete, our BASIS Education Venture Scholarship winner for the class of 2024. Getting back to our student speakers, next up, we have our class salutatorian, Marco Opeña. He will be attending Yale University, double majoring in music and cognitive science. If you ever stop by the Yale campus, you'll find him practicing violin for 5 hours a day and spending his evenings running through the streets of New Haven. Please welcome Marco Opeña.
That was a bit unnecessary, but I'm very grateful to represent the class of 2024 as a speaker today. I think that every single person in this hall, faculty, staff, friends, and family, are equally deserving of our praise and our gratitude. I'd also like to take a moment for a personal round of thanks. I'd like to thank my family for their unyielding support, all my academic teachers from kindergarten to 12th grade, my cross-country and track and field teammates and coaches, and all my mentors and friends that have inspired me along my artistic journey. It doesn't seem very long ago that a 12-year-old me watched my older brother take the same stage and deliver his class salutatory address. Now, I don't remember a single word from that speech, but I do remember my feeling of awe for the graduating students and hopeful anticipation for a distant future in which I, in cap and gown, would also walk the stage. See that this day, so eagerly awaited by us for the past several years, has finally arrived is a poignant reminder of how far we've come, but also how quick the passage of time may seem to us. Before we know it, we'll be graduating college, then we'll be working a full-time job, paying taxes, hopefully, maybe even starting a family, and along the way, we'll be reminiscing of memories such as the one we're creating right now, and wishing we could relive it all again. The best thing we can do for our future selves is to embrace the current moment and recognize its true value. Before we go off to college, let us take this transitionary time to remind ourselves of what we genuinely love to do, whether that's leisurely reading, playing music, or simply engaging in childhood pleasures. Although our time at BASIS has taught us so much, it's been easy amidst the chaos of academic stress and extracurricular overcommitment to forget what makes us truly happy. I also hope that some of us will catch up on so much needed sleep. It's no secret that the greatest enemy of a BASIS student is a good night's rest. But nevertheless, I sincerely hope that all of us will one day enjoy the healing embrace of a full, uninterrupted 8 hours. This day marks both a bittersweet departure from what we've known and grown to love, but also a first step into a vast unknown. Fear and insecurity for the uncertain future are only natural, but let us take solace in the fact that our experiences here at BASIS Scottsdale, whether they evoke positive memories or slightly traumatic ones, have adequately prepared us for the rigors and challenges of academic life and beyond. Class of 2024, it's been a pleasure knowing you all for the past 8 years, some of you for even longer since elementary school. I hope that all our paths will cross again, and I hope that the rest of your lives will be filled with beautiful, happy moments such as this one today. Congratulations again, and whatever the future may hold for you, be kind to yourself and to others. Thank you.
Final speaker of the night is valedictorian Georgia Bukata. You'll be able to check her out next year, sitting courtside with the rest of the Cameron crazies while she attends Duke University, double majoring in mathematics and global health. Please welcome your class valedictorian, Georgia Bukata.
I think I owe Mr. Garvey some Duke UNC tickets after that introduction. All right, Mr. C, let's get started. Good evening, family, friends, teachers, staff, and of course, my 73 esteemed classmates. My name is Georgia Bukata, and I'm honored to be the valedictorian for the class of 2024. Despite Ron dropping a metal water bottle on my head in sixth grade, and years of his dumb blonde jokes. T- Today, for most of us, marks the end of an 8-year journey at BASIS. Our journey began with Mr. CCJ notes, Miss Okawa's recorder performances, Mr. Weaver's just shut up and do math lectures, and for me, more of Mr. CCJ notes. We are here to admit that those CJ signatures from our parents were signed in the bathroom right before class. We have come a long way since middle school award ceremonies, AE, I still don't know what that stands for, and comps, which were somehow 10 times worse than APs. We started high school during COVID, the second biggest challenge of our BASIS careers. The first being making the playoffs in any sport. Shout out to varsity volleyball this season. Despite BASIS being a STEM school and probably half of our parents being in tech, Microsoft Teams proved to be the ultimate challenge. Trust me, Mr. C, we were definitely actively listening to the Macbeth Chapter 5 debrief. But every time you called on us, we just couldn't get those mics to work. We have since mostly figured out how to use technology, except making our essays single-sided. Sorry, Mr. Witz, still working on that one. Through it all, we built a close-knit community. And even through the stressful tests, teacher turnover, and a whole pandemic, we learned to persevere. We have undoubtedly left BASIS better than when we came. The class of 2024 has left its mark. Collectively, we've created dozens of clubs, the library, hosted the first ever senior lock-in, and even made sure the school got a special visit from the Scottsdale Fire Department for our senior prayer. We have also made literal marks on the school, from the exploded red pen on the corkboard during the first week of fifth grade math class, to the painted parking spaces. The class of 24 will forever be a part of the BASIS community, even when the corkboard is replaced and the paint fades. Looking back, I think we now realize how lucky we are to have gotten this education. Because of it, I now know how to utilize all the words of wisdom, explain how aliens are related to biology, or at least how Mr. Carey thinks they are, and speak Spanish with an actual Spanish accent. Well, maybe not. But at least I don't say me llamo es. It's the small one, senor. But in all seriousness, the class of 2024 stands here today because of each and every dedicated teacher who answered our 3 a.m. emails, stayed after school conveniently until rush hour, and who made sure we were prepared for our AP exams. While we may have taken it for granted, I think we will realize that very few teachers are as passionate as BASIS teachers. We are thankful for each of you. While I will not miss those AP days, or the judgmental reaction when someone asks where I go to school and I say BASIS, I will miss the friends who taught me about paneer and jalebi. And that one dish Harini refuses to tell me the name of. I will miss Senor's sarcasm. I will miss Mr. C shouting across the hallway. I will miss Mr. Witz's loud laugh. I will miss Mr. Carey running up to me or throwing chairs in the middle of class. No matter where life takes me, I will miss BASIS. To my classmates, I can't wait to see what you all do next. As I look at you today, I see future computer scientists, researchers, doctors, lawyers, and maybe a future Major League Soccer player. While I will always see you, your silly fifth grade selves, running around the hallways with your K-sits, you all have grown into compassionate, kind, and intelligent people over the last 8 years. So here's to that glow up. And with that, the class of 24 is out.
Thank you, Georgia. And again, thank you to Mr. C and the other student speakers. It's now time for our graduates to begin making their way to the stage to receive their diplomas.
Siddharth Otto.
graduating with high honors. He will be attending the University of Pennsylvania, majoring in biology. He was a national merit finalist, Siddharth Otto. Hassan Al-Azawi, graduating with honors, will be attending the United States Coast Guard Academy, majoring operations research and data analytics, also playing professional soccer. Hassan Al-Azawi. Viraj Yogesh Amin, graduating with honors. He will be attending the University of Missouri, Kansas City for their School of Medicine 6-year accelerated BA MD program, majoring in biology. Yeah. Viraj Yogesh Amin. Anita K. Antia, graduating with high honors. She will be attending Arizona State University, majoring in nursing. Anita K. Antia.
His phone ran out of storage.
Megana Belther, graduating with high honors. She will be attending Barrett, the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in molecular sciences and biotechnology. She is a national merit finalist, Megana Belford. Patishla Barwash, graduating with honors. She will be attending Barrett, the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in chemical engineering. Patishla Barwash. Pervanch Bhatia, graduating with high honors. He will be attending Georgia Tech, majoring in aerospace engineering. He was a national merit finalist, Pervanch Bhatia. Ron Bevin, graduating with honors. He will be attending Virginia Tech, majoring in environmental engineering. Ram Bubby. Georgia Rose Bukata, graduating with high honors. She will be attending Duke University, majoring in mathematics and global health. She was a Coca-Cola finalist, Georgia Rose Bukata. Naimisha Chakravadanula, graduating with high honors. She will be attending the University of Chicago as an undeclared major. She was a national merit finalist, Naimisha Chakravadanula. Catherine Chang, graduating with honors. She will be attending Cornell University, majoring in electrical and computer engineering. Catherine Chang. Alex Paul Konomos, graduating with honors. He will be attending William & Mary, majoring in chemistry. Alexander Paul Konomos. Grant Duty, graduating with honors. He will be attending Boston University, majoring in biomedical engineering. Grant Dewey. Charlie Dolce, graduating with honors. He'll be attending Barrett, the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in biochemistry. Charlie Dolce. Rishi Huba, graduating with honors. He will be attending New York University, majoring in business. Rishi Duba. Aryan Dwivedi, graduating with honors. He will be attending Villanova University, majoring in finance. Aryan Dwivedi. Lauren Hardaway, graduating with honors. She will be attending Carolina University at Chapel Hill, majoring in chemistry, minoring in pharmaceutical sciences. Lauren Hardaway. technical malfunction. Juliana Ishak. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Arizona State University, majoring in biomedical sciences. Juliana Ishak. Rithvik Jandhyala. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the University of Southern California, majoring in physics and computer science. Rithvik Jandhyala. Avanish Jayadev. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Georgia Institute of Technology, majoring in biomedical engineering. He was a national merit finalist. Avanish Jayadev. Mohit Kaylee. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the University of Arizona, majoring in biomedical engineering. Mohit Kaylee. Neha Kanjamala. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in computer science. Neha Kanjamala. Harini Karthikeyan. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending the University of California, San Diego, majoring in biology. Harini Karthikeyan. Adi Kari. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the Honors College at Rutgers University, majoring in biological sciences on the pre-med track. Adi Kari. Sujay Pupuru. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, majoring in information science and finance. Sujay Pupuru. Ethan Kuhn. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in computer science. Ethan Kuhn. Tanisha Kathari. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in biological sciences on the pre-med track. Tanisha Kathari. Victor Lee. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the University of Massachusetts Amherst, majoring in legal studies on the pre-law track. Victor Lee. Sebastian Lako. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Northeastern University, majoring in engineering. Sebastian Lako. Stephanie Lobodănescu. Graduating with honors, she will be attending the Honors College at American University, majoring in international relations and economic on the pre-law track. She was a national merit finalist. Stephanie Lobodănescu. Jolie McCarr. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in biological sciences. Jolie McCarr. Bavia Mucker. Graduating with honors, she will be attending the University of Arizona for her College of Medicine APME program, majoring in public health and health policy. Bavia Mucker. Pranay Mehta. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Baylor University, majoring in biomedical sciences and finance. Pranay Mehta. Panarvish Mitta. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Rice University, majoring in sports medicine and exercise physiology. He was a national merit finalist. Panarvish Mitta. Yeah. Shreya Marala. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending Pennsylvania State University, majoring in pre-medicine for their BSMD program. Shreya Marala. Eilish Nagpal. Graduating with honors, she'll be attending Boston University, majoring in neuroscience on the pre-med track. She was a national merit finalist, Eilish Nagpal. Yusuf Nasser. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in biochemistry. He was a national merit finalist, Yusuf Nasser. Kaitlyn Nath. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending Case Western Reserve University, majoring in molecular and cell biology. Kaitlyn Nath. Nadia Mazin. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending the University of Georgia, majoring in Management Information Systems. Nadia Nazim. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending Johns Hopkins University, majoring in chemical and biomolecular engineering. Tiger Nee. Togildor Ochabal. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending Arizona State University, majoring in chemical engineering. Togildor Ochabal. Daniel Oporowski. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending Arizona State University, majoring in biology. Daniel Oporowski. Tomas Ruben Oporowski. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Arizona State University, majoring in civil engineering. Tomas Ruben Oporowski. Marco Matteo Opeña. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Yale University, majoring in music and cognitive science. He was a national merit finalist, Marco Matteo Opeña. Sean Pears. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending Arizona State University, majoring in mechanical engineering, Sean Pears. Sriyuth. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Brown University, majoring in public policy and economics. She was a Coca-Cola finalist. She is the 2024 U.S. Presidential Scholar, Sriyuth Petty. Alistair P. Graduating with high honors. He will be attending Stanford University, majoring in symbolic systems. National merit finalist, Alistair P. Kavita Sai Param. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Barrett the Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in sociology and urban planning. Kavita Sai Param. Eric Michael Potter. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending Notre Dame University, majoring in aerospace engineering. He is a national merit finalist, Eric Michael Podol. Brody Powell. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the University of Florida, majoring in computer science. Brody Powell. Abhinav Karthik Raghavan. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Carnegie Mellon University, majoring in physics. He was a national merit finalist, Abhinav Karthik Raghavan. Abhinav Raghavan. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending the University of Florida, majoring in neuroscience. Abhinav Ravichand. Aishan Saraswat. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending the University of Arizona State at the Barrett Honors College, majoring in forensic science. Aishan Saraswat. Technical malfunction. Jacob Elias Shamoon. Graduating with honors, he will be attending New York University, majoring in business. He was a national merit finalist, Jacob Elias Shamoon. Anushka Sharma. Graduating with honors, she will be attending the University of Arizona, majoring in medicine, integrative, and practice focused. Anushka Sharma. Anastasia Emily Shelley. Graduating with honors, she'll be attending the University of Arizona W.A. Frankie Honors College, majoring in biology. Anastasia Emily Shelley. Mugi Shembeckin. Graduating with high honors, she will be attending the University of Pacific, majoring in biological sciences in their pre-dental program. Mugi Shembeckin. Zubin Sidhu. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Purdue University, majoring in computer science and a minor in entrepreneurship. Zubin Sidhu. Aditya Vikram Singh. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending Purdue University, majoring in aerospace engineering. Aditya Vikram Singh. Yashvijay Singh. Graduating with honors, he will be attending Barrett Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in electrical engineering. Yashvijay Singh. Jambi Srivastava. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Johns Hopkins University, majoring in neuroscience and computer integrative surgery. She was a national merit finalist, Jambi Srivastava. Mino Srivastava. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Johns Hopkins University, majoring in neuroscience and writing seminars. She was a national merit finalist, Mino Srivastava. Ashwin Suresh. Graduating with honors, he will be attending the University of Arizona's W.A. Frankie Honors College, majoring in chemistry. Ashwin Suresh. Roma Suther. Graduating with honors, she will be attending the University of Arizona's W.A. Frankie Honors College, majoring in molecular and cellular biology. Roma Suther. Pranitha Tangapali. Graduating with honors, she'll be attending Boston University, majoring in biology with a specialization in cell biology, molecular biology, and genetics. Pranitha Tangapali. Arush Fenakaran. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending the University of Texas at Austin, majoring in engineering with a minor in business. Arush Fenakaran. Blake Ethan Chopper. Graduating with honors, he'll be attending the University of Colorado Boulder, majoring in exploratory studies. Blake Ethan Chopper. Aiden P. Tuminello. Graduating with high honors, he'll be attending Yale University, majoring in architecture. Aiden P. Tuminello. Shreya Vidartham. Graduating with honors, she'll be attending the University of California, Berkeley, majoring in chemical engineering. Shreya Vidarthan. Shreyvarun Pavan Kumar Vindator. Graduating with high honors, he will be attending the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, majoring in physics. Shreyvarun Pavan Kumar Vindator. Nayan Lahija. Graduating with honors, she will be attending the University of Arizona's W.A. Frankie Honors College, majoring in medicine and society. Nayan Wahita. Kevin John Williams. Graduating with honors, she will be attending Arizona State University, majoring in in biology and ecology. Kevin John Williams. Andrew Yun-Chen Han, graduating with honors, will be attending the Barrett Honors College at Arizona State University, majoring in computer science. Andrew Xingchen Yang. Benjamin R. Zuckerman. Graduating with honors, will be attending Stony Brook University, majoring in biochemistry. Benjamin R. Zuckerman. Thank you again to everyone for joining us tonight, and congratulations to the students and parents on this accomplishment. Before we finish, we're excited to share the following video created by Neha Kanjamala. For the parents out there, some parts go quick, but if you look out for them, you might see some young, young faces.
Sometimes learning is a
struggle.
When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. It hurts so bad.
Every broken bone.
now if all of our graduates would please stand. And it's time to turn your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left. Everyone, please join me in congratulating the now graduates of the class of 2024.
Thank you. Have you ever